In this video, we'll talk about power transfer, and specifically, we'll talk about three types of power: real power, reactive power, and apparent power. And this can be a little bit confusing for people, so I'm going to start with a basic analogy. So the real part is the important part. So say I want to send you Valerie. So Valerie is our analogy for the real power. She's what I want to send you. I'd like to send you this. She's the valuable thing that you want to receive. But I can't just put her in the mail. She will get hurt or something. You need to actually, to send her, you need to put her in something, right? So we need some sort of container, a box here. So our box is our apparent power. And this box will fit Valerie, but it actually has room for other things as well, right? So the container is the potential for me to send power. So I can put Valerie, which is the thing we want, the real power, into the box, which has a potential to send a certain amount of power. But I also have to put something else in here. Otherwise, she's going to get hurt when she's in the mail or something. So we have to put some sort of packaging in here, too. So we make some nice packaging, something soft, some air too, and that's what we call the reactive power. So the reactive power, you can think of it as a packaging in your parcel that you're sending. And so the power comes in three different parts: the part that we want, which is the real part; the packaging, which is kind of like the necessary part that we need to actually send the power; and the apparent power, which is the potential power that we could send. Now let's look at the more technical part of power transfer. So we divide power into these three different parts: real, reactive, and apparent. The symbol for real is usually capital P, and reactive power is capital Q, and apparent power is a capital S. The units for these are different. So real power is the same as average power. It's the power that we are most familiar with, and that is in watts. So that's the easy part. Reactive power is a little bit weird, so actually we're going to skip to apparent power real quick. Apparent power is the voltage times current, so we actually call it volt amps, VA. So that's the unit for apparent power. And the reactive part, the units are volt, amp, and we have an R, reactive, here. So sometimes we call this VAR, volt, amp, reactive. So those have different units, so you can kind of keep track of the different power. We often represent these types of powers using the power triangle. So you can think about this axis as the real axis going in this direction, the real axis, and then the imaginary axis going in this direction vertically. And on the real part is the real power. So the real power is represented on this side of the triangle, and the imaginary part is representative of the reactive power. So Q is represented on this side, vertical side, and then the longest one, the hypotenuse of the triangle, is the apparent power as shown here. We use this often for sinusoidal waveforms in power transfer, but we can also use these different types of power for non-sinusoidal waveforms, which we will use in power electronics as well. So we've given a basic analogy for the real, reactive, and apparent power in order to send what's really important, the real power, or Valerie. The reactive power is the necessary packaging that you need in order to send the real power. And the apparent power is the box or the container that has the potential power that you could send. So I hope that gives you a basic introduction. We'll be talking more about this later on.